How you going, guys? Curtis from Cutting Edge Engineering. Today's job, we have a 745 dump truck A-frame to repair. Customer states it needs to be line bored. No, the eye is missing, it needs to be replaced. I wasn't aware I was replacing an eye. It was told it was a line boring job. Obviously we can't line bore that. So what we need to do now is replace the eye. I'm gonna have to gouge this eye out. We will have to manufacture a new eye. We'll do 90% of the machining before the eye gets put on. Everything's gonna pull around a little bit when we go and weld it. We do have to brace the A-frame, so I'll put some bits of steel across the legs so it can't walk in or out while I'm welding it. After everything's been welded, we'll throw it up in the mill. I'll finish the ID to size. First step, we're gonna take it outside. I'm gonna gas axe the eye away, then I'll do the cleanup with the gouger. I'll grind all that and prep it, then we'll bring it inside and we'll start machining the new eye. Mil cut sideways, pretty good. Righto, guys, so we've gouged off the old eye material. We've also gouged into the original pocket that was cast into it from the factory. Reason I do that is so I can get in from behind and do a nice big weld in there. Do all the prep on the job, leave the eye alone. We don't want the eye to shrink or to pull out of shape. We'll grind it all up, get it all prepped up. We'll get it back in the workshop and we'll start working on the eye.
Ooh, that one's for safety officer.
What's this?
Ooh, spring roll.
Oh, hydro ball.
Num num num.
What's this? Num 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 num.
Taking my bed. Let's see which one is the favourite. Which one does he like better?
What you got? What's that? What's it? What's this? No, I like the ball. Drop it. Drop it.
Oh, that one's a good chewy ball. Oh,
good bouncy ball. Nom, 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 nom. Right, guys, so we do have an eye in stock that we are going to use. It's not the eye that I have originally made for these before, but this is the closest thing I have in stock in the time frame I have to work in. The piece of plate we're going to be using, it's a piece of 100mm flame cut QT80, so it is a high tensile plate. This is actually a D10 ripper lift rod eye. I need to reduce it from 100mm down to 65. So we'll chuck it in the saw, knock that bit off. We'll do 90% of the machining in the lathe, drill some holes in it for the retaining plate, and then we're going to weld it onto the A-frame. We're at 88.12. cut this way out. Righto guys, so we've carried out all the machining on the eye. I still have 2 mil to remove from the ID. I'll do that after it's been welded to the A-frame. What we've done now, we've set it up in our super indexer. For those who don't know what a super indexer is, it's basically a rotary table, except you can put different plates in the back of it that look like this. And each plate has a different amount of slots cut in it. Once they're set up, you can then accurately put in 4 holes or whatever you're doing, 3 holes and 8. We need 6 holes. I've put the plate inside. I've centered it up using one of our transfer punches. These aren't super critical, being that the hole in the plate's got so much, well, it's a 12 mil hole for a 10 mil bolt, so bit of room to move. We have got them central, and that's going to be good enough for this job.
Where's your toys? Down under there. What's in it? What's under there? What's in there? Get it. Yeah. Hey, where'd you go?
Jump, jump, jump.
Righto guys, we've completed all the machining on the eye for the time being. We do have to weld it to the A-frame now. So we'll get a 100% penetration weld on this. So we'll weld from the top side, bottom side. It should end up pretty well as strong as the standard one was. I was lucky enough a couple of weeks ago to have a A-frame brought in with a broken bolt in one of the flanges. While it was here, I took heaps of photos of it, heaps of measurements. It was good to finally come across one that was in pretty good condition, and we were able to take that information. We've now got it stored on our computer, and from here on in, we know exactly where things belong and exactly where to put them back. So today's job was supposed to be a line boring job. Customer. What we've got to do is gouge all this shit out. Like, stupid fucking thing.
Okay. So right. We got nowhere really. Right, so start again.
Can you imagine how much that operator would have shit his pants when that thing broke?
He would have pooed a little.
He would have pooed a lot. Alright guys, so we've completed the machining on the eye for the top. Oh, I just bit myself on the fucking tongue. I'm sick. Gnarly. Oh. And it should be stronger than the... Well, yep. So we're going to make it as strong as possible. Oh, well, yeah, do it. Right.
Very good.
Right, you still filming me or you're looking down?
I'm filming. What? Where's the camera pointing at?
I don't know. You're looking down here. Like... Yep.
Oh my god. What are you trying to get at?
Right. A few. Handful. Look, YouTube, I do have a flint. No, it's in bananas. Better change that. Blow off. I mean, you know what I mean. But LPG.
Dust.
Wrong yellow.
He's like, why are you putting that there? Yum, 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 yum. You're a good boy. Can you get out of my way, please? Get your toy. What's that?